Hey YouTube, this is ElfSamuel007 here again, and today's gonna be kind of an interesting video, just kind of like, because I got a new gun, but I'm not gonna show you it yet. I'm gonna show you it in a minute. But basically, I'm just gonna go on, a quick test of how all the guns I've had this year. Let's see, I started out, I had my Pilot, I sold that. I actually had the Pilot from previous, but you know, I always count that. I had the Pilot. I sold my Angel, bought the Angel this year, sold it, had an Ion, did not videotape it because I didn't have a camera or anything, sold that, it was actually a really nice Ion, it had a custom painted frame and everything, had an Ion, sold it, loved it, actually I liked it a lot, but yeah, it wasn't my thing, let's see, had the Ion, had the Angel, then I got the Impulse, sold it. Well, no. Then I got the Autococker SR. Just recently sold it. Got the Impulse. Sold it. Got the Trilogy Pump. Sold it. And now I got... Well, I had the Bushmaster. Still have it. Just and it's in parts right now. Because it's still in project mode. But I got a new gun. Actually, it's not new, but I've had it for like maybe a week or so. I just haven't had a chance to do a video on it or anything. But this is gonna piss off a whole bunch of Intimidator owners. I've got System X Enemy. Basically, what the System X Enemy is it's basically an Intimidator for the most part. Uses a lot of the same parts and everything. For the most part. Differences between System X Enemy and the Intimidator is the enemy has got shorter bolt. The bolt stroke is shorter on an enemy. Which is pretty nice. The bolt stroke is shorter on an enemy. I accidentally pulled my thing out of the bolt, so. Bolt stroke shorter. Uses the same RAM. Comes stock with the adjustable RAM cap that doesn't have a bumper, so you don't need bump. This is a bumperless system. The trigger guard is a lot different. It's actually a little bit nicer. You got a lot of room between there. Comes with the. Well, it's basically the System X rag. Enemy rag. This is actually meant for low pressure tanks, but a lot of people use high pressure tanks on them. They actually work well. If you do have a problem with yours though, all you have to do is just change it for an Alias mainspring. It's basically the Alias rag. Cocker threaded, just like every Intimidator. Uses the same solenoid as Intimidators. The frame is similar to all the Intimidators. There's differences though, and I'll get into that in a second. It's got the System X LPR, which is adjustable. Do this knob right here. And it's actually has a lot more volume, so it runs at a lower pressure. Comes with twist lock feed neck. It's actually a really nice twist lock feed neck. And then the other thing is, it's got a proprietary board, basically. Yes, it is a WASP board, but Wicked Air Sports, the guy who invented this gun, or basically is the owner of Wicked Air Sports, or was, and System X. So, and this gun, actually the board was so nice that Alien, their Interceptor, which is their O5 marker, had the same board in them. But overall, it's a really nice gun. It's very similar to Intimidator. It's actually smoother than the last Timmy I had, because I had that 2K2 for a little bit. Really nice. The only problem with it right now is it's got a small LPR leak, but that's not a big deal. But basically what I mean by the difference in the frame is it's humpback frame, but it uses its own board. It doesn't use a Intimidator board. It uses an enemy board or an interceptor board, which is a long flat board. basically the stock mode on these, the Snuck LE, but stock mode on normal enemies is just semi-only, and the starting cap is 20. Right now I have this down to 12 for tourney play. I am eventually going to get a Virtue board for it, because Virtue did make a board for these, but they're discontinued. So I'm trying to find one. The cool thing about the LE boards is on the enemy LE, which the enemy LE was a fade color, like they'd be black and blue and all that, is the LE boards had NXL, and then they had Semi and PSP, which was also cool. But overall, comparing this to that 2K2 Timmy I had, this is about it's a little bit lighter, it's a lot smoother, and it came with a really nice magnetic trigger. The enemies came stock with dual ball bearing triggers, which this one is. Very similar to what you'd say, like see on a critical trigger or something like that. It came with its own front block. Basically, these guns weren't that popular. They beat the hell out of a lot of Intimidators. The guy who invented this, who was also the owner of Wicked Air Sports, actually told Bob Long what he needed to change with his Intimidator to make it better. And this is that gun. Bob Long never took this suggestion. System X didn't last very long, which is, wish they'd still around, but they're not. It was basically just a little video on this. I'll get it shooting, eventually. It does have a little bit of a, LPR leak, but it's just an O-ring that needs to be changed. Talk to you guys later. See you guys.